Greetings, Nicola.
Hello, Karen.
How are you today?
Very good. Very nice to meet you. I think we never met in person, actually.
We haven't. Lovely to meet you too. And greetings from Scotland all the way here. It's a sunny day here in Scotland. How is it in Switzerland today?
Amazingly enough, it's sunny also in Geneva. Let me say. And it's pretty warm as well. I mean, it looks like it's getting warmer and warmer, which is good. I'm half Italian, so I actually do love sun.
Yes, no, and you've been to Scotland, or you know Scotland. The weather here is very, very rarely good, so it's quite nice to feel that spring is sprung at last, and we can look forward to, you know.
Yeah, I actually have pretty good memories about Scotland because I used to, and I was I had a lot of friends in Edinburgh and Glasgow, yeah. And so I was coming to party actually to the. I go back a few years, but it was so much fun.
Listen, it's good fun up here. Actually, there's not an awful lot to do other than drink whiskey and have good times. So.
You bet. No, absolutely.
Oh, well, listen, lovely to see you today. And I believe it was your birthday on Wednesday, so many happy returns.
Thank you very much. I did party enough.
Oh, that's nice. Well, it was my 50th actually last week. So so I've got a couple of years. I've got a couple of years on you, which is, you know.
Getting there. Catching up.
Well, listen, lovely to see you today. And thank you. We're very proud to be your new partner in Scotland with Roger Dubuis, and it's really great to have an opportunity to talk with you and learn a bit more about the brand. I mean, you're a man with watchmaking in your blood. You've been immersed in watchmaking from an early age. Your entire career has been in the trade. You know, what's the culture shift, you know, like moving to Roger Dubuis?
Well, I have to say, as you said, you know, I spent my life into watches. My family has been into watches for three generations. My parents were manufacturing watch cases and bracelets for pretty much all the brands that are out there today, or well, a good part of them. And so I grew up going to the factory, seeing how you make things, talking about movements. You know, my father didn't want me to get watches. They sent me to study finance. And at the end, you know, it was in my blood, as you said, and it's been my life. I love these little objects that capture time in a way, and coming to Roger Dubuis was a kind of at the end of my journey, if I may. Well, my journey is still going to be very long, but you know, it was the in a way crowning my career into this world because. I have to say that I discovered a world which I knew. You know, it's funny to remember that the first cases manufactured by Roger were manufactured by my father. So, you know, I met Roger when I was 20, 25, you know, those years. And then I came back as the CEO of the brand after a while. And again, yeah, I mean, it's a different world here. Even compared to my past experiences as an entrepreneur or with other brands here, it's really the pinnacle of the world of watchmaking and a place where we do things a bit differently, of which I'm very proud. I mean, I didn't invent anything, but it's really an incredible different world from most of our colleagues and competitors today.
Well, you know, I have a lot of respect for being different. You know, we quite often in our industry, we're retailers, we get, you know, we're seen as the disruptors, the young bucks, if you like, although I'm feeling a bit older now. So, you know, to do things differently, you know, takes a lot of innovation, a lot of effort. And, you know, Roger Dubuis makes some of the most flamboyant and expressive watches in the industry. You've even coined your own phrase to describe your philosophy, hyperhorology. Tell me about it. You know, what is hyperhorology?
Well, very cool to talk about it because it's really who we are. It's our segment. It's what somehow we invented, you know. And it's fun because if you think about it, you know, the etymology of the word, hyper stands for beyond, you know, in the Greek word means beyond. And it's a word that has not been used much in the past. It's the world started to use hyper in the last 20 years when everybody really wanted something more. You know, there's always this thing about getting more. And for us, hyperology stands for a way to evolve the traditional high-end watchmaking world, what in Switzerland is called haute horlogerie, into something different, I would say. You know, we always say we take inspiration from the past, and we know very well that Roger himself comes from an important past of in terms of watchmaking, but evolving that in an expressive and contemporary way. And for us, expressive means to play with the movements, with the way the movement can say something, not only work, but actually the way they are conceived, designed, and finished. And contemporary has to do with new shapes, you know, new ways of designing watches, not necessarily the classical way. And I have full respect for all our colleagues, but we are just a bit different. And we think to encapsulate perfectly the future of watchmaking. That's for us, hyper-horology.
Fantastic. And you mentioned that you have met the actual man, Mr. Roger Dubuis. What aspects of his legacy do you hold most dear?
Well, as I said, you know, and I think we have a tremendous respect for the past. This is an industry that was born more than 300 years ago, 400 years ago, and it's become an art. I really believe that it's the art of watchmaking. And so you need to really go and evolve. You need to know what came in the past. And for us, that means to understand exactly what the complications means, what watchmaking has been throughout the years. And this was really the vision of Roger. One of the key things I keep telling to my team is that every brand should stand true to their DNA. The moment you start disrupting and going too much away from what you were created for, then, you know, sometimes even your clients have difficulties in understanding. And for me, for us, it was always about that. The vision was set by Roger at the very beginning, and we are still doing exactly what he wanted to do at that time. So evolving the world of watchmaking, taking into consideration the tradition and the past. And the fact that even today, we keep adhering to all the rules of the Poinçon de Genève, for example, the Geneva seal, mean really that we take care of what was created in Geneva, of the industry. We take care of the whole tradition of watchmaking, but with our different way of seeing things.
And given your, you know, respect for the past and the ongoing trend right now for vintage revivals, any plans for a late 90s archive raid?
You know, it's a very good question. I have to say, not the first one. As you said, there is an ongoing trend for revivals, vintage, and so on. I think our history has been pretty short. You know, we started just a bit more than 25 years ago. And I think that given what I just told you, we look at the future of watchmaking. And, you know, our purpose, and we worked a lot this year, you know, everybody talks about purpose, economy, and so on. For us, our purpose is going beyond. So continue exploring the world of watchmaking, continue pushing the boundaries of watchmaking to the next level. With that in mind, for us, it's difficult to look at backward. I mean, we need to constantly project ourselves forward. And so, you know, our heritage is the future. And for the moment, I'm not planning to do any re-edition or any look at the back of the history of Roger Dubuis. Voilà.
Bravo. You've mentioned a Roger Dubuis tribe in past interviews. What sort of man or woman does it take to qualify for that tribe?
Well, very good question again. I love, you know, this tribe idea. You know, it's I never like to segment too much. You know, I believe that we are all so different, and that I really like for people to express themselves into being different. And probably this is exactly the point. It's a question of attitude. Like, you know, to talk and to work with friends, with people who want to choose, who are able to choose, who want to enjoy life. It's really this you know, we often talk about hedonism, which is the ability, the possibility to enjoy life. And life is full of beautiful things, pieces of art, you name it. I mean, moments to enjoy. That's why our two territories of expression have to do with adrenaline, and it's a strong emotion. It's with the motorsport world, and with what we call expressive singularity, this idea of being extravagant, of being able to for each one to express themselves. And this is really what Roger Doux is about. It's about a world where everybody can really enjoy life at its best. Let me say with things that do not come easily, what we do is difficult to manufacture, difficult to find most of the times, and we want it to be like that. You know, it takes years for us to conceive maybe just one caliber, just one watch. And so it cannot be available to everybody. It's something quite amazing, quite unique. And we want people to get to us to look for that specific thing. And not, you know, another thing that I keep saying is that we love this idea that, you know, the world is telling you that to be cool, you need to wear something. Okay, we are saying, no, I mean, wear whatever you want, but make sure you enjoy what you're wearing on a daily basis. Make sure you enjoy who you are and what you do. And that's the kind of tribe we are. It's a different world. And more, I keep saying to my team that wearing a Roger Louis, it's a sign of being a certain kind of person. You know, the tribe is about that. It's about enjoying being part of a different way of being. And then the sign is what you put on your wrist.
Well, I'm on that note, I'm enjoying wearing my Spider Hurricane. There you go. So, voila. And that brings me actually naturally to Lamborghini, because I'm wearing the Hurricane skeleton just now, and you know, it's a perfect fit car wise for your brand. Just, you know, listening to what you're talking about, the tribe there, how did this partnership come about? You know, it's a great partnership, and there's been many of them in our industry, but your partnership seems strong, and it seems to be technically also integrated in terms of the designs, so you know, I'm really excited to hear about that.
Absolutely. Well, I have to say I wasn't there when the partnership started. I arrived just after. But again, as an Italian, I really cherished the moment we decided to work with them. I mean, I grew up with the myth of the Miura, you know, or the Countach, these amazing cars. And I think it's as you said, it's a perfect partnership. We represent excellences in what we do in two different industries. And the important thing that we represent excellence, not only for what we do, but the way we do it, how we do it. And this is very important to me. I was talking about craftsmanship. I was talking about the dedication and the attention, the passion that we have behind what we do on a daily basis. And this is exactly the same at Lamborghini. We share the same values. And that's why the, you know, partnership comes almost seamlessly. It's fun to work together. It's fun to meet every time. Our designers meet regularly with their designers, and we look together how the world of design is evolving. Our technical people meet with their technical people, and we see what we can share between materials, between new ideas, between the technique. You know, the thing is that we have both a chassis and we have both an engine. And so it's fun on how we can talk and discuss the evolution of these two things into something amazing. And I think they are doing an amazing job. And there is just a new CEO was joining the brand, Stephen Winkelmann. We met a couple of weeks ago, and I am sure that we'll continue doing great things together.
Yeah. I mean, I guess the most natural partnerships, well, the best partnerships are those that feel most natural and don't actually feel like a partnership. They almost feel like a friendship. You know what I mean? And it seems to be...
As I said, we have fun together.
Yeah.
You know, we meet and we go often, for example, to the Super Trofeo events around the world, where we share, you know, we invite clients, they invite clients, and we give racing experiences to our clients and vice versa. And it's fun. As you said, it comes naturally. That's perfect. That's exactly how it should be.
And in terms of other dream partnerships, in terms of people as well as brands, what else have you got up your sleeve, or what else do you aspire towards?
Well, as I said, we worked a lot in the past few years on the motorsport side, so on this adrenaline factor territory, mostly thanks to Lamborghini and Pirelli, which are our two partners in that world. And then we are starting today to developing our second territory of expression, which I mentioned before, the expressive singularity, in which we really want to connect with, let me say, the world of expression. And so I can tell you in advance, we started something in the last year with Cash Chirane, the spatial artist on with which we worked for the Excalibur Superbia, a magnificent piece. It was a new double flying tourbillon, all encrusted with baguette diamonds and blue sapphires, which created this incredible game of light and refraction and so on. And we're going to continue. Now, I cannot tell you much because it's going to happen soon, but we're going to continue working in the world of contemporary art. So connecting with someone who sees and lives the reality in a different way. We go back to this disruptive approach, this peculiar way of interpreting reality and life. And I think we found some very good connections once again with some amazing individuals and artists.
So I can't wait to hear. You heard it here first, folks. So you mentioned earlier that, you know, your family has been involved in watchmaking, and you were, from an early age, have been involved in watchmaking too. But when did you first get watches? You know what I mean? When you first really understood what it was, you know?
Yes, I think because of my family, it was very early, the very early age. I remember going to the factory, and I love working with the prototypists, you know, those guys who were taking a piece of metal and transforming it into something working in a case, in a movement, in components. And I had rapidly to understand how to use the machine and what the machines were for. And at the end, how every single part that we were creating had a function. Now, the beauty of that, and the beauty, if I may, also of Roger Dubuis, is that of shaping technical things into something beautiful. And that was what fascinated me when I was super young, you know, the idea of making my own watch and to think that it was a beautiful thing, even not exactly straight or correct the way I wanted. And this is still, amazingly enough, this is exactly what we do at Roger Dubuis. We bend the technique so to make a beautiful thing, a beautiful object at the end. And I might say probably I was 10 years old, 11 years old, when I really started understanding, not understanding, maybe that's too much, because, you know, then there is this philosophical idea about what time is and the fact that you can capture something that it's impossible to capture, that it's so fascinating. And I keep, you know, thinking about even today, it's something amazing about making watches, you know.
I know. We're very lucky, aren't we, to be in the industries that we work in. We're very blessed. How have your tastes changed since being at Roger Dubuis in terms of watches?
I can't really say that my taste has changed. I mean, I have my idea in terms of what a watch should be in terms of design. I always made watches very open. So when I started seeing these incredible skeletonized calibers that we do at Roger Dubuis with very little metal on the top, I think it was exactly what I always tried to do. With my own brand, I was doing a very similar kind of watches some 10 years ago. I have to say that here it's all about, and I repeat myself, evolution. And for example, in the new double tourbillon that we just launched, we have reworked the lines of our iconic Excalibur original collection into something more contemporary, you know, with dense lines, eliminating the curves, working really on the volume of the case, so to make it more contemporary and to go along with the tendencies of design. I think it's something that fully expresses my way of seeing watches and that of my team, because at the end, whatever we do here is the work of a team of amazing professionals, of amazing people who have been living this industry like I have been for years. Everything we achieve, everything we do today, it's the expression of the team and of normally many years of ideas, thinking, trying, and so on. And, you know, maybe it's a good moment for me to present a new thing that we are launching at Roger Dubuis. I mentioned that before, but it's really taking life now. It's what we call the Q Lab. in honor of the Mr. Q that you probably know well from James Bond movies, which always fascinated me, this idea of a crazy laboratory where he was going and finding, discovering all these new tools that he could use. Well, the same idea we had here, and we are starting now the actual works to restructure completely a part of our building, of our manufacture. And it's going to be this crazy place where all our luckiest clients will have access to, and where they will really discover about the inventive, the creativity, the craziness of José Dubuis and our watchmakers. There will be an area dedicated to new materials. There will be machines working while people will be visiting. It's a place where we really want to aggregate all the creativity of the brand, of this maison, and give also space to people that normally wouldn't have access to the engine of the brand. You know, why the CFO cannot have great ideas about the escapement of a movement? Why, and so this is going to be a virtual and physical place where to aggregate the minds, the beautiful minds of José Luis. And so I can't wait to see the final thing, because also the design is pretty cool, and to invite you and all the people that will want to come to see what our Q-Lab and what José Luis is about.
Oh, it sounds amazing. We're going to see a watch on James Bond then next, you know. Just kidding.
Yes, it's going to be complicated.
Oh, well, listen, it's a Friday afternoon, and we want to put our feet up after a long week, no doubt. So my last question for you today. So looking forward, you've mentioned Q-Lab. Looking forward to the next 5 years, what can we expect to see?
Here I have to use my thing. I mean, expect the unexpected. That's really José Dubuis. And we have plenty of things, as I said, also thanks to these new ideas we are putting together. We have plenty of things coming. Because of the long cycles, I'm seeing already what we're going to launch in 3 years, most probably. And I'm just amazed by the creativity, by the ideas, the inventive of my team, and about how we keep evolving this incredible industry, this incredible world. So once again, stay tuned, because we will not disappoint our friends and our tribe.
Okay. Well, Nicola, thank you so much for your time today. It's been a pleasure talking to you. We're, as I said, very proud to be a new partner here in Scotland. I hope soon enough you'll have a chance to come and visit us, and we'll take you on a tour. And we really look forward to seeing your new products coming and really developing this partnership with you. So it's really, really interesting to hear a little bit more about the brand, get into a little bit more depth behind it. So thank you so much for your time. Really, really appreciate it.
Well, thank you, Karen. Same, likewise. I mean, I can't wait to start traveling again, meeting people, meeting our clients around the world, visiting places. So I'm really looking forward to see you in person, to come to visit Rocks, and to get back to Scotland.
Okay. And of course, we'll take you to some of your old haunts, no doubt.
Thank you very much.
All the best. Have a lovely weekend. See you.
All the best.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.